نستعينه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed in the Qur'an one of the greatest surahs, one of the greatest revelations that's ever been revealed. And he says about it, بَعْضَوْذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَاكَ سَبَعًا مِنَ الْمَثَانِ وَالْقُرْآنَ الْعَظِيمِ We have given you these seven oft-repeated verses and the Qur'an. And these seven oft-repeated verses are the Surah Fatiha. And this surah is the fifth surah to be revealed in the first surah to complete in its revelation. We know that the surahs were revealed part little by little, but this is the first one to complete to be finished completely in revelation. And so before we begin to speak about the surah, we have to seek refuge from shaitan, the one who wants us to not appreciate the Qur'an and the one who leads us away from the Qur'an. So we say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. We seek refuge from Satan the accursed, the one who put his rationale over the rationale of Allah, and the one who thought that his decision was the better decision, the decision that was higher than Allah's. And then we start in the first ayah, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most beneficent. And so Allah starts with His own name, one of the highest names, what's known as Lafzul Jalala. And He starts with that name and He describes Himself and He says, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the most merciful, the most beneficent, and whatever mercy, whatever benefit we see is a manifestation of the mercy and the benefit that Allah gives us. And we know that Allah, that there's no benefit and no mercy except through Allah. And then we start the first ayah, the next ayah we know, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All praise is due to Allah, the Lord of all of creation, the Lord of the worlds. And so every praise that we give is only due to Allah. When we praise someone else, in reality we're praising Allah, because Allah is the one that created the situation that we are praising. And so whether the thing is that our souls are sometimes the one that don't praise Allah, but the sun, the moon, the stars, the trees that are green, the animals, the insects, and everything in between, all of these things praise Allah, whether you like it or not. All of these things praise Allah. And we need to recognize that we are the only ones that go against the will of Allah sometimes. Not against the will of Allah, we go against the orders of Allah. Because nothing can go against the will of Allah. And so Allah tells us, He describes Himself as the Lord of all the worlds. And so then He says the next ayah, again a repetition, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the most merciful, the most beneficent, again. And this is a constant reminder that Allah is always going to have mercy for us and always going to have benefit for us. And actually both of these words both mean mercy. But Ar-Rahman is the merciful who gives mercy to the disobedient, to the non-believers, and to those who are unappreciative of Allah, and the ones who are appreciative of Allah, the ones who are obedient, and the ones who believe. So this mercy applies to everyone, but Ar-Rahim is specific. Ar-Rahim is the mercy that we receive, the Muslims receive on the Day of Judgment through the Shafa'ah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And may Allah make us of those who get the Shafa'ah. And so this is a specific mercy that we're given. And then you need to remember that whether you want to appreciate, obey, or disobey, whatever you want to do, that Allah is, there's going to be a day when you're going to have to present yourself to Allah. And He says, Maliki Yawmiddin, the master, the owner of the Day of Judgment. That whether you believed or not, on that day you're going to have to present your deeds to Allah, and He's going to show you what you did, and what you did wrong, and what you did right, and what you deserve. And He says, اِقْرَأْ كِتَابَكَ in Surah Al-Isra. Read your book, the book of your deeds. كَفَى بِنَفْسِكَ الْيَوْمَ عَلَيْكَ حَسِيبًا. That what you've done, your book is enough to show you what you deserve. That this is enough to show you what you deserve. So that if we don't want to appreciate that Allah is the Lord of the worlds, and that He's the most merciful, the most beneficent, then we're going to have to show our face to Allah on that day with whatever we came with. And then Allah will say, look at your deeds, what you deserve. And then we make a transition from speaking about Allah to speaking to Allah in the Qur'an. And the reason this is because we by this point in the prayer, we should have turned our hearts towards Allah and realize that we're speaking to Allah, and this is our prayer is a communication with Allah. And let's appreciate that fact. So we say, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. Only you do we worship, and only you do we ask help from. And Allah is the only one who deserves worship, because He is the Rabbil Alameen. So He says in the first ayah, He's the Rabbil Alameen. And then in the fourth ayah, He says that He is the one that we say that He is the one we worship, and the only one we ask for help from, because He's the only one deserving of that. And we don't worship the idols of money and the idols of business and the idols of ourselves, the idols that we create for ourselves. We worship only Allah. And Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he narrates a hadith Qudsi, which is a hadith with Allah speaks with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam paraphrases, and so these aren't part of the Quran. And the Prophet ﷺ says that Allah said, قَسَمْتُ صَلَاةَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ عَبْدِي نِصَيْنِ فَنِصْفُهَا لِي وَنِصْفُهَا لِعَبْدِي. That I have divided the prayer, as in I've divided the Fatiha. That our prayer is not complete without the Fatiha. I've divided the Fatiha into two halves. The first half is for me, but the second half is for my servant. And so we realize that in the first three ayat, Allah describes Himself, but then it moves to our, and He says, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ. And it ends there, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ, that's for Allah. The worship we're giving to Allah, even though it does not benefit in one bit, and it only benefits us. If we leave it, it doesn't benefit Allah. If we do it, it doesn't benefit Allah, it only benefits us. But then He says, وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. And in that ayah, in that portion, we realize that we've moved to asking for ourselves. And we're asking for ourselves because He is the Rabbil Alameen. And no one else can give what He gives. Not even iota of worship is due to anyone else. And then we ask by the next ayah, we ask, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. Guide us to the straight path, the path of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who guided us. And the path, some of the ulama say that this path is, that the path of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the straight path is the path, is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we ask because Allah is Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. We notice that there is a correlation. Allah is Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, so He'll guide us to the straight path. All we have to do is ask, and all we have to do is work towards being on that straight path. And we want to be on the straight path because Allah is Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. We need to realize that this path, Islam, Iman, Ihsan, the Quran, what we've been given is the ultimate mercy. It's the only way we're going to make it to our destination. The only way we're going to make it to our destination, we need to realize our destination is not this world, but our destination is the Akhirah. And this world is just a stop on the highway that is the Deen, the highway that is our religion. And we don't want to become distracted by the stops on the highway. We want to actually get to our destination. And the Sirat al-Mustaqim is the Sunnah. And we need to implement the Sunnah and realize that the Sunnah is not just extra credit. That implementing the Sunnah is not extra credit. It's not fine if you just do your phone. That's not okay. We can't reduce the Islam to just what's fard. We need to also realize that Islam also contains the Sunnah, the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what He's given us. And that if we don't appreciate that He's given that to us, then we're going to become like those who were unappreciative of it before. So then the next ayah, صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. The path of those whom You favored, the pious predecessors, the righteous that came before us, and even those who came before our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Those nations were also given a sunnah that they were supposed to follow, but the thing is they lost the way. And that's why we have our deen, because they lost their way, we need a deen for the entire world. And so they lost their deen, and they became the ones that earned the anger of Allah. And we asked Allah not to make us among those, but they became those who earned the anger of Allah and left the sunnahs of their prophets and what they were given. And when they left that, Allah said, you know, Allah showed that He doesn't need them. Allah simply replaced them with a new ummah. And we know we're the last ummah, but we need to appreciate that we're the last ummah, we're the best ummah. That Musa alayhi salam wanted to be part of this ummah. He didn't want to be a prophet of this ummah. First he asked to be a prophet, but Allah said no. Then he said, I want to be part of the ummah, but Allah said, you can't be part of this ummah, you're already given your own ummah. So we're blessed to be part of this ummah. And to be gathered here on the day of Jumu'ah. Jumu'ah comes from the root to be gathered. That's what the word comes from. And on top of that, it's also the day of Eid. It's a day of mercy, a day of celebration. And we should celebrate the fact that we are given opportunities to celebrate and opportunities to enjoy with each other, to enjoy the deen that we've been given. And we don't want to be among those who didn't appreciate and didn't enjoy the deen and they got lost along the way. Those are the dhalleen, the ones who got lost along the way and stopped maybe on the highway that is the religion, and they stopped and they stopped to look out all the sights that were on the highway, and they never realized, they forgot they were supposed to get to a destination until it was too late. And it became too late and they were replaced. So we don't want to be among those who lose ourselves in the less important aspects of our lives. You know, sometimes we find arguments about, where do I place my hands? Is it here? Is it to my sides? Is it on my chest? Where is it? Those aren't the things that are important. Allah's not looking for where you put your hands. You should know where to put your hands in the prayer, obviously. But that's not what Allah's looking for. He's looking for your heart and to know that you appreciate the deen. And so, inshallah, let's allow ourselves to appreciate the deen, to accept the blessings that we've been given, and not to allow the blessings to leave us. Because Allah will take the blessings if we don't appreciate it. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين واستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. If you came late, really the message I'm trying to get across is that the Fatiha has meaning, and we recite it every single day, at least 17 times, 40 times if you're not leaving the sunnahs. So it's our job to at least appreciate the fact that we've been given these seven great ayat, that no nation before us has been given something like this. This is the seven jewels of the Qur'an. These seven jewels have not been given to anyone else. No other nation has been given something like this. An opportunity for us to first of all know our Lord, and then to ask our Lord, and then to speak to our Lord in our prayer. It's a unique, we're in a really unique situation where we're allowed to speak with our Lord. And every single day Allah gives us a reminder through this surah that we have, that He is the Lord of the worlds, that He is the merciful, that He is the one that's going to judge you if you don't appreciate those facts. And then He reminds you to ask, to recognize that first of all we worship Him and ask help from Him, but then to ask for the help from Him and help in the matter of the deen. We can ask for help in other things, but the most important thing is to ask for help in the matter of the deen. And if we don't ask for the help and don't ask for help in the matter of the deen and we let it go, we'll never see the benefit, and then the ummah will be gone, and we'll be left without the sunnah, without guidance, and we'll be lost, and we'll become amongst those who lost the way, who Allah showed their anger upon and replaced. And so they remember that this way is the way of the Prophet ﷺ, it is the Prophet ﷺ, that his way is the only way that works right now. It's relevant at all times, it'll never become irrelevant. There's always a way to implement his sunnah. There's nothing irrelevant in his sunnah. So we should recognize that and try to find ways to implement his sunnah. Even if it's one small thing every single day, if you can do it, do it. And recognize that this Prophet ﷺ was the greatest blessing we have. And Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. That Allah and His angels send the blessings and the peace upon the Prophet ﷺ, And he commands us to send the blessings and the peace on the Prophet ﷺ. That this is an action that Allah and his angels do. Because we need to be in constant gratitude of that. So with that, we say, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Mawlana Muhammad wa ala ali Sayyidina Mawlana Muhammad. Allahumma anta as-salam wa minka as-salam tabaraka ya dhal jalali wal ikram hayyina wa adkhilna dar as-salam rabbana atina fid dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina adhaban nar rabbana hab lana min azwajina wa dhurriyyatina qurrata a'yun waj'alna lil muttaqina imama inna allaha wa malaikatahu yusalluna 'alan nabi ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu 'alayhi wa sallimu taslima allahumma salli 'ala sayyidina mawlana muhammad wa 'ala ali sayyidina mawlana muhammad wa barik wa salli 'alayhi inna allaha ya'muru bil 'adli wal ihsani wa ita'i dhil qurba وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقم الصلاة